Oracle's EPM system or the Enterprise Performance Management System. Okay. This EPM system, okay, at the very lowest level, you have all your data sources present. Okay. If you have a look on the screen, okay, we have various data sources available. Okay, we can extract data from an OLTP system. OLTP stands for Online Transaction Processing System. We could pull data from a data warehouse. As this itself can act as a data source. Okay, so basically what we are trying to say is, when you are trying to implement EPM, you can actually also have SBase as a data source. You could have other ERP systems like SAP, Oracle, Siebel, okay, any custom based ERP, like you could have primitive ERPs like MFG Pro also. You could have Excel or an XML file as a data source. Okay. And the business processes that are generating data can also be used as a data source. When I say business processes, okay, let us consider an organization where employees fill in the timesheets. Okay. Now this filling of timesheets is at the end of the day going to generate some data for me. This data probably could be billing to the project or can be used to measure employee performance. Okay. Even such kind of data can be used as my data source. Okay. See, what this EPM is going to do is, it can pull data from various data sources and then integrate all the systems into one interface. So once you have this data, using a Fusion middleware tools, you can facilitate the data movement and get a business intelligence foundation ready. Okay, when I say Fusion middleware, there would be tools like the application server, data management tools. You have MDM, master data management tool, financial data quality management. Okay. So there are many data management tools, application servers. Okay, you could have an out-of-box portal. Okay, all those tools will facilitate and I will lay the foundation of my BI.
Okay, Vicky, one thing, does this Fusion middleware, are you referring to the, is it a kind of an ETL you are referring to?
Yes, the ETL tools will fall into this space, the Fusion middleware.
Okay, that's fine. So,
okay. Not only ETL, there could be other components also, the application servers, portals, everything will come in the Fusion middleware.
So the data transformation will take place over here?
Over here, correct. Data.
Okay.
Yes, correct.
Okay.
Then you have the...
Okay.
Yeah, Raza, go ahead.
No, I was just asking, you just go ahead. I was just asking, in which of these categories Hyperion falls into, like financial performance management application or operational?
Yes, that is what I will be explaining.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So then these will lay the foundation for my business intelligence. When I say foundation, okay, here I will have the common interface called workspace. I will have the security services using shared services, okay, and even SBase would be sitting over here. Okay. Now actually this EPM, okay, Oracle, what it has done is, they have actually acquired Hyperion, and at a similar time they also acquire a product called as Siebel Analytics. Okay. Which now they have renamed it as Oracle Business Intelligence Enterprise Edition, or in short, they call it as OBIEE. Okay. So even that is integrated into this EPM system. So you could have either Sbase or you could have a BI server, which is typically used in OBIEE, BI Foundation Server. Okay. Now, if you see in the third particular step, this is a little disjoint step. Okay. Here I have two components. One, I have the financial performance management application, and other I have the operational BI apps. Okay. Prior to this being integrated into one enterprise performance management system, they were actually two separate modules or systems, one being the Hyperion, other being the BI apps or OBI plus edition. Okay. Financial performance management applications are the Hyperion applications. Okay. Applications such as Hyperion Planning, Hyperion Financial Management, Hyperion Performance Scorecard, Strategic Finance, okay. All these Hyperion financial applications are part of this financial performance management application. Okay. Whereas this BI apps, actually earlier part of Siebel Analytics or now part of OBI, okay, have got operational applications. Okay, applications like sales analytics, HR analytics, marketing analytics, all those kind of analytics are part of this space. Okay. And these applications are basically, you retrieve or interact with this application using various client tools. You could have a web-based client tool. You could use Microsoft Office, Excel, PowerPoint, etc. to interact with this application. You could use a desktop-based application, okay, like a Windows client. Okay. You could use a mobile app. Okay. To tell you honestly, I have never ever used a mobile app to access this information, but Oracle says that it is possible to do it. Okay. And it can be embedded in other applications. So you have a set of APIs available which you can use to embed it in other applications. Okay, all these applications, including the financial performance management and the BI app, gives me a complete range of products which can help me to implement those products in an organization for the performance management of that organization. And that is why it is called as Enterprise Performance Management System. Okay, so you require any solution. You require a financial solution in terms of consolidation, planning and budgeting, corporate planning, scorecarding. You can do it using financial performance management application. Any kind of other solution like marketing analytics, sales analytics, HR analytics, I think there are a lot of other analytics also available. Okay. So those can be done using the operational BI applications. So this gives you a complete suite of applications which can be implemented in your organization for the performance management.
Okay, Vicky, I have one question.
Yeah, Raja, tell me.
Looking at this slide, I'm just wondering, in a particular organization, is it possible that these data sources which you specified, in the beginning, like OLTP, ODS, data warehouse, SBS.
Right.
So is it possible that depending upon the requirement of the organization, like the same data source talks to the financial performance management application as well as to the operational BI applications?
Very much possible. Very much possible. So what exactly we are telling is we are trying to retrieve data from these sources. Whether you use it for financial performance application or whether you use it for BI apps totally depends on the type of data contained in your data source.
Okay.
If your data source has got financial data and operational data, you can use it for both. Okay. If it doesn't have, then obviously you cannot. Okay. If it is containing only financial data, then you cannot use it for operational purpose. Maybe to a limited extent, but not to a full-fledged extent.
Okay.
Okay. So, for example, let's say when I talk about business process, okay, here, I have an employee timesheet data. This may not be applicable for a financial performance management application.
Yeah. Correct.
Okay. Yeah. So, it depends on the data contained in the data source and what is the kind of analysis that you are trying to perform or what is the solution that you are trying to build.
Okay.
Is it clear? Any questions? Kamar, you have any questions? Just a second, guys. I don't know why this guy is coming up. Let us take a look at some of the common Hyperion components. Okay, just to show you, the foundation service comprises of the shared services and the smart view. Okay, now shared services is a common interface, okay, through which we can manage the security for all the Hyperion modules. Okay, when I say security, we can manage the users, groups, and the access for those users and groups. Then you have the data management tools, okay, which is also called as your ETL tools. Okay. Some of the examples being DRM, DIM, data relationship management, data integration management, financial data quality management. Okay, and nowadays actually with Hyperion planning, you have this tool called ODI, Oracle Data Integrator. Okay, there are few others available. These are just some of the data management I have shown here. Then before we look at reporting, we have the SBase component. SBase itself has got various components in terms of SBase server and client. We have SBase administration services used to perform admin related activities in SBase. We have provider services. Now, this provider services provides us an interface between Microsoft Office application and SBase. Okay. When I spoke about SmartView, okay, I did not tell what exactly SmartView is. Okay. The reason was that first I wanted to come to provider services. Okay. So, SmartView is actually a client add-in that will integrate with Office applications, and especially it has a very good integration with Microsoft Office Excel. Okay, and this SmartView, okay, will talk to my provider services, which in turn will talk to SBase. So provider services provides me that interface. Then we have integration services. These integration services integrate a relational data source with SBase. Okay. Now what happens is SBase typically stores summary level data because it is a BI application which would be typically be accessed by managers or executives who may not be bothered more about the transaction data. Like for example, an executive may be interested in looking monthly sales. He may not be bothered about looking at daily sales or hourly sales. Okay. But in some cases, if you want to look at the detailed data, you can integrate SBase and a relational database. So you can look at the monthly sales in SBase, and then if you want to look at the weekly or daily sales, you can drill down to a relational database. Okay, which is done using the integration services, which integrates SBase and the relational database.
So, Vicky, Raza here.
Yeah, Raza, tell me.
On first of all, you know, I just on the shared services, you said that it is used to, you know, for security and maintenance of users, you know, maintenance of users,
right,
user groups. So, like, if I'm using Hyperion planning with SBase and I would like to create some users, so I would be using shared services for that?
Yes, you are correct.
And then what are administration services? What is the difference between...
Sorry, what is?
And
yeah,
administration.
See, what happens is, when you are using SBase, okay, you have to define an application, you have to create a database, okay. All those has to be done using the admin services.
Okay, okay. Got it. It's see, earlier days... It's more related to database.
Yes, correct. See, earlier days, okay, you could also do the security part using the admin services. Okay, oh. But with the latest version, Oracle has got a clear-cut direction. They say that nothing doing through SBase, you should do everything through the shared services.
Okay.
So if you are using SBase just as a standalone mode, that is the time you can use the admin services for also managing your security. Okay. But when you put it in a EPM space, okay, you know, it becomes very difficult to synchronize the security if you have it in admin services and shared services separately. Okay, that is why, you know, rather than using the admin services, you do everything via shared services. You have a single interface to manage all the security, not only for SBase, but for all other modules, including financial applications and the reporting modules. And then, yeah, Raza, is it okay or you have anything else?
Yeah, that's just to like what you have explained. I am just
right.
Would like to know about security, not in much detail. But I would like to know, like, do you implement the security at the SBase level as well as the application level? And by application, I mean Hyperion planning.
Right. Don't worry about security. We will be covering the security. But just to tell you, security is based on the application level.
Okay, that's fine.
In fact, when you look at Hyperion planning, you will not be actually looking at the SBase security. We will be looking at the planning security because it is much more, you know, there are much more levels of security in planning.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay. Okay. Then we have the financial performance management applications such as planning, financial management, strategic finance, and performance scorecard. Okay, all of them used for specific purpose. Okay, like planning used for planning, budgeting, forecasting, financial management for consolidation, strategic finance for corporate planning, and performance scorecard for organization scorecarding. And on top of these applications and SBase, you have a range of reporting tools. You have tools such as financial reporting, web analysis, interactive reporting, and production reporting. Nowadays, as I told you, since it is integrated with OBI, you can also use the OBI reporting tool to report out of SBase and other financial performance applications. But again, what happens is, for those you have to buy a separate license. Okay, but these tools come bundled along with the financial performance application. Moving ahead, let us take a look at the functionalities that one can achieve in SBase. Starting with sales tracking and analysis. So I can do sales tracking and analysis in SBase. I can do financial consolidation and reporting. Okay. See, I can do this financial consolidation and reporting, but nowadays the focus for doing your consolidation has actually shifted from SBase to Hyperion Financial Management. Okay. So Oracle says that for doing the consolidation, the tool that you have to use is HFM. Okay. So Hyperion Financial Management is the tool you will be, normally company will be using to do their consolidation. Okay. But again, there is nothing that stops you from doing it in Hyperion SBase. One can do customer and profitability analysis. You can do product line analysis. Executive information system or management information systems can be done on SBase. You could do performance and variance reporting. And you can do planning and budgeting. Okay. Again, with planning and budgeting, now Oracle says that instead of using only SBase, you should use Hyperion planning to do your planning and budgeting.
Okay, Vicky, one thing, looking at this diagram, it seems that SBase, this multi-dimensional database of SBase, seems to have a lot of capability to perform all these tasks. But since now Oracle has come up with a different product marketing plan with reference to these Hyperion products. So what they are saying, like you have just said, the planning and budgeting is possible within SBase, but Oracle recommends that you use Hyperion planning for that. But what is, like, if you don't use Hyperion planning, can't we use SBase and then integrate it with some other reporting tool in the front end? And because from my experience, it seems that when Oracle says we recommend, in other way, what they're saying is that they kind of not interested in us going that path. They are more interested in us going the path they recommend. And they kind of force it in a way that they don't support. Sometimes they don't support the way we want to do it. So I'm just wondering, if we use SBase to do all these tasks, what is the difference actually? You're using Hyperion.
Yeah, exactly. Good question, Praza. See, what happens is SBase is capable of doing it. Okay. And I say Hyperion planning, even though you are using planning, okay, at the back end, it is still using Hyperion SBase.
Yeah, that's what my confusion. I was kind of confused.
Now, Now having a planning, solution in place, what you are going to achieve is it's going to come with certain pre-built features, okay, which may or may not be possible to build in SBase, or which may be very time-consuming for an organization to build in SBase. Okay. Like, for example, when you talk about planning, okay, it allows you to have a budget approval process in place, okay, which you cannot do directly in SBase. Okay. It gives you a web interface, which SBase will not give SDS, you cannot enter data through a web interface. Then you have to build your own web interface using an API, you know, using some APIs. You will have to build your own custom application. And what has happened is, what has happened is they have got a very proper direction in that they are not going to now market only SDS. They will either go and sell Hyperion planning or they will go and sell financial management. Okay.
So what happened is in planning, when I buy Hyperion planning, I am like implicitly, it is like taken for granted that I have to also buy SDS for sure.
So SDS comes bundled as a part of Hyperion planning.
Okay.
So when you buy Hyperion planning, the SDS part will be bundled.
Okay. Thanks.
Okay. Let's move ahead. Okay. This is the SDS architecture. Okay, I will just quickly run through this. You have two types of databases available in SDS. You have a block storage and you have a aggregate storage. Okay, block storage is typically used when you have more of calculations and less of roll-ups or aggregations. And aggregate storage is used when you have very minimal calculations and more of roll-ups. Okay. In fact, with a tool such as Hyperion planning, you cannot use aggregate storage. The thing that you can use is a block storage. Okay. Now, these databases can be accessed by various components. So, you have an admin console which can access this database using the administration services as the interface. We have Smart View, which can use these databases using the provider services as the interface. Then I have an integration services console, which I can use to talk to SDS and a relational data source using the integration services. So it will talk to both of them. Okay. And I can also make my own application using the APIs, which can directly talk to SDS using the TCP/IP. Okay. There is another client add-in available, which is called as the SDS spreadsheet add-in. Okay. This SDS spreadsheet add-in is also a client add-in which integrates with Microsoft Excel. Okay. Now this add-in, the only problem with this add-in is it can only connect to SDS or only talk to SDS, whereas my Smart View can talk to all the Hyperion modules including planning, HFM and the reporting part. Okay. However, the advantage with this add-in is that it will not use any provider services. It can directly connect to the SDS. So sometimes you will see that performance is little faster when you use the SDS spreadsheet add-in for SDS. So I've just listed the SDS components. Okay. We have the block storage, aggregate storage, admin services, Smart View, spreadsheet add-in. Okay. Then you have two command line languages called MATLAB and ESSCMD. Okay. They are also used to the administration task, but through a command line. Okay. When we use admin console, there is a interface which we can use to carry out the administration, but if you want to do the administration using command line, then you can use MATLAB or ESSCMD. We have MDX, which is a query based language, and we have our APIs available to build our own set of applications. And additionally, we have the integration services. This is the screenshot of the admin console. Actually, I would suggest don't worry on this site now, because I will show you exactly what it is. Okay. These are the production environment components of an Edge-based application. So typically your database object will have outline file, the OTL, where your dimensions and hierarchies are stored. We will have the rule files, calculation scripts, where we will write the calculations, smart view or SD spreadsheet add-in. Okay. Typically, you should use only one of them and not both, because they are used for the same functionality, and you could have integration services. Okay. Let us quickly glance through each of them. Okay. Outline is my structure of the dimension hierarchy. So here is where I would define consolidation and mathematical relationship between the member. Okay. And I will be doing this through an editor called Outline Editor. I have rule files which I can use to build my dimensions or load data in Edge-based. So I can map to many data sources and pull data from there to either build my hierarchy or I can just use it to load data in Edge-based. See, each of these components we will be looking in detail in our following classes. I am just showing you what are the components available. Then we have calculation scripts. Okay. See, ideally the process is that to load the input data in the Edge-based database, then you create a calculation script. Okay, which will have the business logic, and you run that logic on your database to get a fully calculated database. So I can perform lot of complex calculations as well. Smart View, as I told you, it's a client that is embedded in a spreadsheet application. It enables us to retrieve data, create ad hoc reports, and do analysis, ad hoc analysis. It provides me integration with Microsoft Office products. Okay. And the most important point about SmartView is that it provides me a single Excel interface for multiple products. That means I can access multiple Hyperion components. Similar to SmartView, I also have the Edge-based spreadsheet add-in. This is also embedded in the spreadsheet and also allows me to do the same functionality of retrieving the data, creating ad hoc reports, and analyzing the data. Okay. But it provides interface only with the Edge-based server. I cannot use this add-in for other Hyperion modules. And if you see the picture below, it shows that it can directly talk to the SD server. You don't need any middle interface for this. And the integration services, as I told you, you can integrate your data RDBMS with SDS using the integration services as an interface. So you can actually drill from SDS to the relational database. Okay, this particular analysis of analyzing your data from SDS as well as the relational database is called as hybrid analysis. So what we have taken a look at is describing the multidimensional analysis. We have looked at the Oracle's EPM system and we have looked at describing SDS. So we looked at the SDS architecture and we also looked at the various components of a block storage production environment. Any questions?
Okay, Vicky.
Yeah, Raza.
I think I wanted to know. First of all, this is the second class, and I understand you have been going through the presentation. So I'm just wondering, can we get that documentation?
Today, as I told you, after the first two classes, I will be sending you. Actually, I'm not sure if you have already received an email. The documentation and the notes, everything are supposed to be given in the weekend time.
Okay.
Okay, but since we are already nearing the weekend, so I would be passing it to you guys today. So by tomorrow, I think you should have it because I would send it to the coordinator who will actually pass it to you guys.
Okay, and one more thing.
Okay. So first we will do is, what we will do is, I will first pass you guys the files that you need to download for installation and set up your environment so that you can carry out the exercises and the labs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, let us take a look at how do we create an application and the database in SDS. Okay. Let me just end this presentation. Okay. Now to create an application, okay, what I will do is I will open a component called admin console. So I go into the programs, Oracle EPM system, I click on SDS, click on administration services, and I have a component called administration services console. So I click on this, okay, which will start my console. Okay. So I provide the credentials, the user ID and password. Guys, one second. I think you'll have to give me 2 minutes. These services have gone down. Kamar, just to answer your question. See, I won't be giving you the presentation, but I would be giving you guys notes on this presentation, okay, which are based on this presentation by the chapters, and it could be little more detailed, explaining you all the points in a detailed manner. Okay, so it serves as a good reference. The presentations are very summarized, okay, and some of the things just by looking at the point you may not be able to understand. So I will be sending you set of notes based on these presentations. So what I have done is I have connected to the administration server. Okay, I have logged on to it, and here I have an option to connect or open my SBase server. So within this SBase server, currently I am using my local machine. So I am using this server called as Abhivan. This is actually the name of my local computer. Okay, so I open this SBase server. Okay, and within this SBase server, I will have an option called application. So I have applications as well as the security also available over here. Okay, so I just expand this applications, and I will see all the available applications that are present in SBase. Now what I am going to do is we want to create a new application. Okay. So let me start by creating a new application. See, creation of application is very easy. I can just say file, new, or I can just right click on the application and say create application. So either way is fine, both will actually do the same thing. So let me just start by saying file, new. Okay, or let me just say create application using block storage. Okay. So it will now ask me the application name. Let me call it as app1. Okay, see, for training purposes, I am just using a name as app1. But in a real-time scenario, you should actually try to name the application as according to your business model. Like, example, if you are doing a planning, you could call it as a plan app. Or a budgeting app, you could call it as a budget app. Okay, so I am just saying app1. The moment I say app1, it is now creating the application in the backend. Okay. So you see, this app1 has been created over here. Okay. There is a small tick sign along with the app which says that this application is already started. If you look in this console, okay, at the bottom, there is a message panel. Okay. Whatever commands you run or whatever things you do in the admin console, it will show status messages at the bottom. Okay. Like for example, now we try to create an application. It says that Abhivan, which is a server one, which is a server dot app one, which is the application name. The command was create application and it succeeded. The time of the command was so and so time and it is succeeded. So all the messages will be shown over here. Now let me blow up my or expand my application. So I click on this plus sign. Okay. Currently there is nothing below it. Now I want to create a database for this app1. Again, creation of the database is also very simple. I can use the same methodology, file new, or I can right click on the application and say create database. The moment I say create database, okay, I have to pass three parameters. One is the server name, other is the application, and thirdly the database name. Let's say I will try to have a budget or a plan in this database. So I will just give the name of this database. Okay, I am calling it as plan 1. Okay, again this has to typically you should give the name as matching to the model, whether you are doing planning or sales or you know what kind of analytics. Depending on that you can decide the name. Okay. Just one thing to remember, the name should not exceed 8 characters. So I say okay, and it has created a database below the application. Now I will expand that this database. Okay. When I expand this database, there are few objects that appear by default below this database. So we will start off by looking at this outline. So what I do is I just double click on this outline and it opens a outline editor. Currently this outline editor is totally blank. Okay. There is nothing in this outline editor. So what I am going to do is I am going to start by creating dimensions in my outline. Okay. Now the number of dimensions that you have to create is going to be dependent on your business requirement. So I would typically identify a dimension has a parameter on which data is analyzed. Okay. So for this particular training application, I have decided to create 5 dimensions, which means all my data is going to be represented by those 5 dimensions. Okay. Let me start by creating the dimensions. Okay. So this is my outline. It's here is the outline editor for server.application.database. I click on this particular icon which says add a child to the selected member. So I just click over here and the very first dimension that I am going to create is the account dimension, or let me call it as measures dimension. Okay. So I can call it account measure. The name of the dimension is totally dependent on what you decide. Okay. So I call it as account. I hit the enter key, then automatically it allows me to create the next dimension. So the next dimension I say I want to create is time period. The third dimension I will create is a scenario. Okay, where I will typically store the functional scenarios like actual, budget, forecast, variance, etc. The fourth dimension that I will create is product, and the fifth that I am going to create is market. So I have created these 5 dimensions. Okay. Now the number of dimensions is, as I told you, is totally dependent on the requirement. It could vary from app to app. Some application could have 8, some could have 9, some could have 6. I am using 5. That number is totally variable for application to application. Okay. Usually, during my implementation experience, I have seen that you never go beyond 13 to 14 dimensions. Okay. That's the maximum number of dimensions that I have seen or even heard from my colleagues. Okay. The reason being, because after that 13, 14 dimension, it becomes very difficult to analyze the data. Because then for each data value, you have to specify those 15 dimension members. Now, as far as SBase is concerned, there is no limit to the number of dimensions. I can go on creating. Okay. But just remember, with each dimension that you create, you are actually going to make your database structure complex. Okay. That is why when you actually move to a planning or a performance management application, they have restricted the number of dimensions you can create. But in SBase, it's open. You can go on creating n number of dimensions. See, again, what happens is, now Kamar has one question, that is performance an issue? Okay. See, we are talking about a business intelligence application. Okay. Here, the performance is a primary criteria. Okay. See, when you talk about a BI app, okay, this application is going to be used by a minimum, at least a manager or above level. And if a performance is not that great, then they might, lose interest in using your application. Okay. See, the main advantage of a BI app is that it can give you reports at a click of buttons. Okay. So that is why when you create the dimensions, you have to make sure, because the more number of dimensions, the bigger will be your database size, and in due course of time, it will hamper the performance, maybe not by much, but by little, but again depends on the kind of dimensions and the data that is coming in. Okay. So I follow a thumb rule that I will make a dimension only if it is a parameter to analyze the data. Kamar, correct, your question, what you have said is correct. When you buy a planning application, okay, see what happens is, any planning application will give you some minimum six standard dimensions. Okay, and then again after those six standard dimensions, you will still have to create your own custom dimension, which has to be built from scratch. The standard dimensions will be available to you when you create the application. Okay. Don't worry about the planning app. We will be actually covering how to build an app in planning, and I will be actually showing you what dimensions are being built in planning and everything. But let's now focus on SBase. Here I have to build everything from start. There is nothing which will come by default. So now I have created these five dimensions. I just click on save. Okay. So these five dimensions are now saved in my outline. Now if I close and open the outline again, it will be present. Okay. Before I move forward, just let me show you what has happened at the back end. So I will just go to the folder where I have done the installation. So it is, I think, C:Hyperion. Okay. Within this, I have a folder called products. Okay. Within the products, I have a folder called SBase. And within the SBase, I have a folder called SBase server. Now, within this SBase server, I have a folder called app. Okay. This folder basically means the application folder. If I double click on this folder, okay, I will be able to see the app one folder. Okay, this is the application folder of the application that we created. If I double click on this application, I will see the folder for my database. So we created the database plan 1, so I see the folder plan 1. Okay. And within this plan 1, I will have all the database related files. Okay. All these files are automatically managed by SDS except for the OTL file, which is the outline file. This is the file which will be modified each time I modify the outline in the outline editor. Okay, so the structure or the outline that we define here is actually getting stored in this file. Okay. Now let me start by creating a small hierarchy. Okay. Before that, we saw that I created a database within the application. Okay. Just to let you know that it is not necessary that I have only one database. I can create multiple databases within an application. Okay. Like for example, if I show you this sample application, you see that there are three databases within this application. Okay, but again, as a best practice, or I have a thumb rule follow that if I am doing only an SDS implementation, I will create one database per application. Okay, so if I have a need to make another database, I will create another application. Okay. This is what I follow for a SDS implementation. For a planning implementation, I will use up to a maximum of 3 databases per application. Okay. Again, this is just a best practice. Yeah. This is just a best practice that is typically followed. Okay. Now, Raza, your question is why there is a need to create multiple DB. Okay. The answer is very simple. Okay. If you have multiple models, okay, let's say you are building a model, one for your financial model where you are going to capture the profit and loss, balance sheet, etc., and you have another model where you are just capturing your capex related information, or maybe you are doing a payroll module. So depending on the model, you can create multiple DBs. Okay. And as I told you, typically for an SDS implementation, I will create one DB per app. Okay, if I want to use multiple DB, I will create multiple apps. But for planning, okay, I would create up to three databases. Reason being that planning itself will typically invariably it will have there would be a need for the organization to have multiple plans. Okay, like for example, an organization may have a requirement to do planning based on the market. Okay, so based on the market scenario, they may prepare 3 sets of plans. One could be base case, another could be best case, third one could be the worst case. So what will happen is, based on those market scenario, whether the market is good, I would use best case or worst case or a normal case. So now let me just start by creating one of the simplest hierarchy, that is the time period hierarchy. To create a hierarchy, I can either right click and say add child, or I can also select the icons available over here. Okay, I have 2 icons, child and a sibling. Okay. Child means the member will be created below it. Sibling means the member will be created parallel to it. So let me add a child to the time period first. I call it as year total. Now I don't want to create anything parallel to it, so I am just going to again select year total and say add child. Within the year total, I will create the quarters. So I say Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4. And within the quarters, I will just quickly create the months. Typically, you should create this month based on the financial, financial year that your organization is following. Okay. Like many countries will have the financial year from Jan to December. Some countries could have differently. Like here in India, we follow the financial year from April to March. So in that case, I will start from April and end it with March. So, I am just quickly adding those members. Okay. So, what I have done is I have built a simple hierarchy for the time period. Okay, it has year total, four quarters and the months within the quarter. Okay. Notice that alongside the month there is a plus sign. Okay, this plus sign is called as a consolidation operator. Okay. Which means what? Which means that the value of January, February and March will be added to quarter one. Okay. So my quarter one value will be derived from addition of Jan plus Feb plus March. Okay. I have various consolidation operators available. Okay. I have fraction, I have multiplication, division, percentage, I have exclude from consolidation. That means I can ignore the consolidation. Okay. And I have never consolidate. See, changing the consolidation is very simple. If I want to change the consolidation operator of January, I just need to click on that sign. And you see now instead of plus, a minus sign shows or a multiplication. So I have just created this simple hierarchy. I am going to say save. Okay. Now I am just going to right click on this Q1 member and I will say edit member properties. This is where I can define lot of things for a member or the properties for the member. There are various options or tabs available. I can define the information. I can define attributes, association, UDAs and formula. Okay. As we move along, we would be actually looking on these options. Okay. But first, let me start with one of the simplest one, that is the aliases. Here I can define the alias for my member. So let's say Q1, I want to call it as quarter 1. Okay. I can also define the consolidation operator from year. Or I can even change the name from year. There are few other things like a two-pass calculation and a data storage which we will look in the following classes. UDS, Kamar, your question is UDS stands for user defined attribute. That is correct. UDS do stand for user defined attributes. Okay. Basically, those are attributes or tags based on which I will filter my data. Okay. Don't worry about it right now. We will be actually looking at the UDS with proper example. So I just say okay. So you see now there is a alias that has come to Q1 which is saying quarter 1. Okay. Let me just quickly add few more members in scenario. I am going to enter two members. I will say actual and I will say budget. Here I don't want to consolidate them, so I say ignore and exclude again. Let me add product. I am going to add two categories of products. I will say audio and video. Okay. And below audio, I am going to say, let's say, CD, radio, maybe iPod. Okay. And below video, let me say camera, camcorder, okay, or let's say VCR. So I'm just defining some products. Okay, let me define some market. Let me call it as East, West, South. Okay. Let me define some members in East. Let me say New York, Boston. Okay. Likewise, I can also define members below West and South. Okay. And now let me define the account hierarchy. Okay. I'm just going to add one member called profit. I'm going to define a very small and simple profit hierarchy. Okay. Below profit, I am going to define margin and expenses. Okay. Now my profit is going to be defined as margin minus expenses. And below margin, let me define sales and cost of goods sold. Okay. See, typically I'm just creating a very small hierarchy for profit, probably from a manufacturing company's perspective. Okay. So sales minus cost of goods sold. Okay. Now expenses, let me define few expenses. Okay. Let me say admin expenses, marketing expense, and MISC expense. Okay. And these will be all added. It will be added to get me the total expenses. Okay. Notice that alongside each member, okay, there is a less than, a number, and a greater sign. Okay, this actually tells me how many member is below that. So like account has got one, so it means that account will have one member below it. Okay. Likewise, profit has got two members below it. So looking at this number, I can easily tell that how many members are below it. Okay. Now just let me verify this outline. So I outline is verified successfully, and let me just save it. Okay. See, currently we do not have any data. Everything is blank, but we are just defining hierarchy for my application. Okay. To look at it, what I am going to do is I am just going to connect to SDS using Excel. So I am going to connect using the SDS spreadsheet add-in. So I click on add-ins. Raja, your question being, what does verify do? Verify will actually verify that there are no errors in your outline. Like, you know, probably if you use invalid name or, you know, any invalid character, then it will verify whether your outline is correct or not. Okay, there are few more things it verifies. Okay, like it will verify the shared member thing and all, which I will, you know, you will understand once we do those topics. Okay, but basically it will verify whether your outline is correct or not. Okay. So I am just going to connect to SDS. And here I can now see the list of the applications, our application being App1. So I'm just going to click on this application and let me double click. Now when I double click, I will get all the five dimensions that we have built. Notice now I can actually drill within each dimension. Okay, like if I double click on accounts, I can see the profit member. I think Tamar, you missed it. Let me show you again. First, what I did is I selected the add-in. Okay, from the add-in, I selected SDS. And I selected connect, then I gave the user ID and password and selected my application and got connected to my application. Now I did nothing, I just selected one cell and double clicked on that cell. The moment I double clicked, I got all the five dimensions of my application. Okay. Now you notice that I can drill down within these dimensions. Okay. So I will just double click on account. I see profit below it. I double click on profit. I see the margin and expenses. I double click on margin. I see sales and goods. I am using SBase spreadsheet add-in. If you see add-in and it, the name says SBase. So this stands for SBase spreadsheet add-in. Okay. This is directly connecting to the SBase spreadsheet. Okay. See, I have Hyperion Smart View also, but I am not using that right now because there are certain steps that you need to do to connect to SBase using Hyperion Smart View. Okay. So this is a direct connectivity to SBase. Now I will also drill down to other things. I will drill down to scenario. So you see I have got actual budget and the scenario member. Okay. Let's say I want to look only at the budget number. So I select budget. I say SBase keep only. Okay. So it will keep only budget. It will remove the others. Okay. Same way I am going to drill to product. Okay, let's say I drill again into video, I see camera, I drill into audio, I see radio, CD. Let's say now I want to just use CD, so I say SDS, keep only. Okay. I drill to market, East, New York, I want only New York right now, so I say again SDS, keep only. And now, let's say I want to move the New York CD and budget in the column. So I'm just going to say S based pivot. Okay. I'm going to drill to the time period and year total. And let's say I'm going to look only at quarter one. And then I drill to quarter one. And again I say S based pivot. So now I got a, I am able to represent the data the way I want to. Okay. Currently, there is no data in it. Okay. So that is why I am getting everything as a missing value. Okay. Let us target first only at the sales account. Okay. So I am just going to say SBase keep only and now I have only the sales account. Okay. Let me start by writing back some sales data into the SBase database. Okay. So I am going to enter some values over here. Let's say I enter 1000, 1200, 1500. See, again, as I told you, these values have to be represented by all the five dimensions. So this 1000 actually stands for sales, budgeted sales in January for CD in New York. Same way this 1200 stands for budgeted sales in February for CD in New York. So now what I am going to do is I am just going to write back this value in SBase. So I say SBase lock and SBase send. Okay. So this method of writing back data back to SBase is called as a lock and send method. If I want to verify whether the values have gone, I can just delete these values, okay, and just say SBase retrieve. And you see these values will come. Okay. Now the question is, what about my Q1 value? Okay. To get my Q1 value, I just first again go back to the hierarchy. And I just see that my Q1 value is actually defined as a addition of Jan plus Feb plus March. Okay. So the value that I should expect at Q1 should be 1000 plus 1200 plus 1500, which comes to 3700. Why I should get this value? Because Q1 is defined as addition of Jan, Feb, March. Now to get this value, I will just run a default calculation. Okay. See, by default, there is one calculation available in SBase, which will calculate your entire database. Okay. So I'm just going to say SBase calculation. There is a default calculation script. I say calculate. And now if I say SBase retrieve, I will give the value over here. This is coming only because of the logical relationship that we have defined in our application. Okay. Now Raja, at the start you had asked me one question, how do I query my database? Okay. Now to answer your question right now, we will not do query. We just pull out the data by specifying these dimensions over here. Okay. Like example, if you want to select another account over here, I can just click on this cell and say SBase member selection. And here I can select the account that I want. Okay, let's say I want to have COGS, cost of goods sold. So I just select that, say OK, and thus member will come over here. Now if I say SBase retrieve, you get the value over here.
Okay, I think
currently it is blank, but if there was any value, that value will be shown over here. So this is how you can retrieve the data from the database.
Okay, that's fine, because I have worked previously on the OLAP server, you know, Oracle OLAP, and you know, we used to query, you know, OLAP from the back end.
Right. Right.
So I'm just thinking on the same lines that, you know, maybe as
there is a query language available, MDX, okay, but typically nobody uses that, okay, because whatever you want to query can be done using Excel.
Okay.
Okay. So nobody actually uses that, and even when you go in planning, everything can be queried using the web form. Okay. And it is much more simpler rather than writing your query. Okay. You can just select the combination over here and you will get the related values. You can look at the related values. Okay. The other option is even the writing back is simple. Okay. So if I have to change this value tomorrow, I just enter the value, I say lock and send, and the value gets written back. Okay. But with the query, then it becomes little complex. So the usage of query has actually faded over the time. Okay. I have typically not seen anybody using those queries right now, except if you are designing your or developing your own custom application. Okay. Then you would have to typically write some queries in your code. See, likewise, if I add any other account or if the, let's say, the outline is getting updated. Okay. Now, let's say to profit, I am just adding one sibling and I am adding an account called inventory, which I will just say exclude. And the moment I save it, okay, I can now select that account from SBase. Okay. So, it is getting updated real time. This is coming in SBase now. So now I can actually select that account. Hello? Hello?
Yes.
Can you hear me? Hello? Yes. Sorry, actually I got disconnected on the call, so I just called in again.
Okay.
Yeah. So what we have done today is we have looked at the architecture of SBase. Okay. We have looked at how to create an application in SBase. Okay. And we have looked at how to you create the outline hierarchy and how to access the same using Microsoft Excel using the SBase spreadsheet add-in. Okay. So we looked at how to retrieve data, send data, connecting to SBase, and we have also looked at creating hierarchies, where we also looked at how to create an alias and what are the consolidation operators. Along with it, we also looked what is the effect at the back end. Okay, so you will have a folder for your database, for your application, for your database, and you will have a OTL file. Now you see currently the size has increased from 2 KB to 3 KB. Okay. Before we end, I would just like to show you one thing. Okay. Moving on, moving or cut copying paste in SBase is a very simple task. Okay. Let's say if I want to move a product CD from audio to video, I can either just drag it, or if I don't want to drag it, I can just right click and use cut copy and paste it. Okay. Just one rule to remember. If you cut and paste, or if you move a member from one place to another, the children will also be moved. Okay. Or if you delete a parent, its children will also be automatically deleted. Okay. So if I, let's say if I delete audio, its children CD, radio and iPod will also be deleted. Okay. So let's say if I just delete it, you see all the children have also gone. So, what we have actually done today is we have looked at the creation of outlines and the members along with how to use consolidation operators and aliases. Okay. Any questions you guys have so far? Yes, Kama, tell me. You have any question? Okay. Yeah. See, when I say create database, that is not an Oracle database. That is a SDS database. Okay. It has got nothing to do with Oracle. Okay. Any other questions, Kamal? I'll come to you.
Kamar is asking about documentation on how to download SDS and its components.
Yes. That I will send it to you by tomorrow morning. You should have it. Okay.
Okay.
So I will send it to you. That documentation not only will have SDS, it will also have the link to it will also tell you what you need to download for SDS and for Hyperion planning.
Okay, and Vicky, just a question, like when we do this, when we create this outline, is it like typically when we are almost done with our requirements, when we are done for our business requirements, then we set about creating these outlines or dimensions or stuff like that?
Yes, when you are done with your requirements, correct.
Okay. And normally in a production environment, I think this would be a, right now you are showing us your desktop, but I think as the database grows, I think the size becomes very huge. So I think the size becomes very huge and it must be running on a server with lots of space.
You are correct. Yes, Kamal. It should be running on a server. Okay, I am showing you on my laptop. Which actually is not a server replica. It has just got sample and dummy models or training applications.
Okay.
In real time, the data size could get huge and you should be using a server.
And
okay.
We don't
the
see...
The recommended servers are either you should use Windows 2003, 2008 or Linux or Solaris.
Okay. So, you don't see any issue with us downloading the application and running it from our laptop? No issues with that.
No, there won't be issues at running your laptop because you will not be having real-time data. Or even if you have, one or two applications can be run because your laptop or machine will be accessed only by you and not by multiple users at a time.
Okay, Kamar has asked a question about the version. Like, can you please
yes.
tell us?
I was actually about to reply that when you actually asked. See what, when I will send you the documentation, it will have the link and it will guide you as to where you need to download and what version you need to download. Just to give you a heads up, the version is 11.1.1.3. This is the version. Okay. This documentation will tell you the link, then it will tell you which version to select and which particular files you need to download. See, Hyperion is a huge space. Okay, there would be lots and lots of files available. Okay, so it will tell you which are the specific ones that you need to download. Okay. Any other questions, Kamar, Raza? Okay. Raza has said, Kamar, what about you? Any other questions? Thanks, Kamar. Thanks for your feedback.
Very good class. I would also say
Like it's,
See, Raza, I told yesterday also, my objective is to, you know, give you the best possible, you know, training that I can using the online mode.
Yeah, I think I really enjoyed this class. It's like the time has passed and it's almost 1 hour 45 minutes and it's going to be very interesting.
Yeah, yeah. See, I told you the timing is actually dependent on the topic. Okay, if it goes even beyond 2 hours, I'm okay with it. Okay, yesterday I wanted to stop because these all I wouldn't have been able to cover in one topic. And actually, I also had a client call which I had to take up.
Okay, that's fine. Thank you. Thank you for your time.
Okay, Raza. Okay, Kamar. Let's catch up with you guys tomorrow, same time.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Yeah, bye.